Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. It's Shruts and Jojo with you.
Hello, yo yo.
Okay, what's up? You know what we are reacting to?
Yes, I do know. Nescafe Basement.
Yay, we're going back to season 4. And this is episode 6. And it's a vocalist whose voice we just can't get over. I think we'll never get over this. Is Altamash.
Yes.
So we are doing a song called Talash, which is apparently a Junoon song. Junoon's second album ka gana hai, and this is a recreation.
So Junoon, man, they used to be so good. Like full rocker gana hoga fir to ye.
Yeah.
Okay, Junoon ka. Maybe I've heard it. I'm sure I've heard it. Yeah.
Really, I don't think I have. But Junoon songs are anyway so powerful. And then if you're gonna attempt a recreation of it,
I'm saying Junoon ka song. I must have heard. Yeah.
Not this one.
Not this.
I don't think I've heard the original also. But I'm just saying that I think I have full faith in Zulfi and Altamash also. And of course, the whole...
Oh, yeah. 100%. If their previous songs are anything to go by, anyone can do it, they can. Yes. You know? Anyone, no one else can. Even attempt it. But the way those guys do it, oof, too much. Yes. I'm ready.
And I want to give a shout out to the person who's been requesting this regularly. Every day I get a DM saying day 15 of requesting Talash, day 17. So now we have reached today. Today is day 20, Mr. Rehanis Khan. So,
chalo aagi request. Thank you.
I do look at DMs and I do keep things on the list. So patience will be rewarded. Day 20, pay. We are doing this. Let's go. It might release on day 25 or whatever, but we are doing it on day 20. We're recording this. Okay. Let's go for it. Talash.
Yes.
1, 2, 3, play.
Nescafe Basement, Season 4.
Thank you. Those guys were in some other zone.
You know,
they were in another zone. We were just watching them. They were in some... okay.
They took me with them. Mm-hmm. I was in no other zone. I was right there with them. I was with them. At one point, it was very difficult for me to keep my eyes open because the music was like... I was so into it. I just had to keep my eyes shut and feel it. Just feel it. And oh my... Like, you know, normally I've always heard when they say that the same brain waves get activated. And I think I've spoken about it earlier as well. That jab aap classical music sunte ho and jab aap rock music sunte ho, it's the same brain waves that get activated. So usually when
we talked about this, yeah,
right. So when we fusion songs mein jab hum sunte hain, you know, it's like usually how songs are fused is ke thoda sa classical, classical aayega, thode, you know, instruments, jo subcontinent wale instruments hain, wo aayenge. Phir uske baad suddenly it goes into like, you know, those strings and guitars and the electronics and, you know, it goes into that and then it comes back. So the jugalbandi happens. In this one, it was not one is coming and then the other and alternating. In this, both were present from the start right to the end together. Mm. And that, the magic of that, it was such a complete and a perfect song. I did not expect to be pulled into it the way I was. Mm. I honestly, how long was this? This was a 9-minute song. To me, in my experience, the song was about 2 minutes.
Yeah.
I was so into it. Like, I didn't realize it. I didn't. I can't get over it. Please, you tell us.
No, because we were like, oh, it's a 9-minute song. It's actually 8 minutes. It's ended at 8:17. But my thing is, it felt very short because time kind of moves slowly when you zone out, right? And this happened to me at a concert, by the way. It was a 2-hour concert, and I had my eyes closed. I was standing right in front of the speaker, and from the moment my eyes shut till the moment they opened, I felt like it had been 5 minutes, but it had been 2 hours. And when my eyes opened, I
magic,
was,
magic.
It was
of
just
music.
The music. It was nothing else. I literally entered that venue, went straight, got my spot, and I didn't move. And it felt like 5 minutes. It was just the power of the music. right? So I know exactly what you're saying. But it was, where do we begin in this? We've gone crazy praising Altamash's vocals. He, if anyone can pull off an Ali Azmat song and do justice to it, this is the man.
It's him. Yes.
Yeah. I mean,
he's the only one.
It's near impossible to cover an Ali Azmat song because we know what he's capable of behind the mic, right? It's like the range that he has and the kind of places that he goes, it's kind of crazy. And Altamash does so much justice to what he's already done before, what Ali's done before, and brings in his own personality and his own, a take to it.
Yeah.
Of course, the texture and timbre of his voice helps because it's so unique and so good for rock, right? It's just...
And it's so unassuming. Yeah. You look at him and you're like, aisi awaaz to, you know, is gale se nikal hi nahi sakti. And then next, you're like dumbfound because you're like...
Ah. And the thing is, the part where he went really deep and, you know, the bassy bit. Yeah. And then when he goes high, it's like the koi effort dal hi nahi raha hai, but I mean, dal raha hai, he's in his zone.
Yeah.
But it just feels like it's like flowing so easily from him. So... Oh, so good.
You know that bit when only there was like a beat from the drum coming, and then they were just repeating that little thing again and again. And at one point I felt like the person who was on the guitar was also like just hitting the drum with the beat, right?
Yeah.
I felt like with the drum beat, kya bolte hain usko, jisse wo beat kehte hain. I felt like at one point he was playing the guitar also with that, and then he just kind of went there. And I was like, am I seeing this wrong? Is that what's going on? Like some percussion thing is also happening? I mean, because it's totally possible. Anything can happen.
Yeah.
Like, you know, with these guys, I don't put them like past anything. Kuch bhi kar sakte hain ye log. So like, they're just...
This
major
was,
respect.
Yeah, full respect to the whole band, like the whole crew and everyone on this. It was just I would say that the sitar played such a major role. Of course, the lead guitar. Yeah, and the rhythm guitar, Sherry Khatak. Even Usman Sheikh, lead guitar. I have to give a special shout out to the bass player, Melvin Arthur. Because even when all these instruments were in the lead, the bass was so good. I was just like, I was focusing on the bass for some reason, and it was blowing my mind because it was the kind of what's the word for
segue?
It? It was that thread that was keeping it all together, but it was kind of it was the bass line where it was keeping the mood and the environment in the same place while
it was like the tempo. It was like it was almost like the
I was like, the bass is so good here. It just, especially when the lead guitar was doing its thing, it was so good.
The sitar right now, by the way, has put me in that zone that I'm a hafte ke liye, mujhe pata hai, ab main sirf sitar sunne wali. I'm just constantly, because I'm a huge sitar fan anyway. I listen to a lot of sitar.
My dad used to learn the sitar when I was growing up. I used to sit and just watch him do his practice.
I've learned the sitar. Like, we used to have these huge orchestras in our prize giving. Like, you know, once a year, our prize giving used to happen. Yeah. So we used to do like, we had to. So that's when I mean, only that time I played the sitar, I played the violin. So we were introduced to all these instruments and we had to play them. One set of orchestra. So my God, that sitar,
it was in the starting. Did you notice in the starting portion of the song, it was actually doing what the guitar would normally do in a rock track, right?
Yes.
I was like, oh my God, only Zulfi can program the music like this. I've just in
Zulfi
shock.
To matlab music composition na ho, like what is he doing? This is amazing. I can't get over it.
The tabla, the cello, I can go on about every instrument. In the middle, when you knew, because you could see one of the Leo brothers, he was playing the cello and he was getting into the zone, he was getting ready. I was like, okay, now this one's coming. And then he started, I was like, oh, this is so good. What is happening?
So, I somehow, after the start, I couldn't register individually anyone. Because I'm honestly telling you, I didn't expect to get pulled in so drastically. Nice. I got so pulled in that I don't remember any one person in all of it. All I remember is the collective effect that it was going on. So I'm so glad that you noticed all this, because abhi agar baat karni hoti, mujhe to kuch yaad hi nahi hai. I just think, wow.
It was I was trying to pay attention to everything that was going on, because I was like, this looks like a full on arrangement. So. What can we say? What can we say?
After all what we've spoken,
we have I don't think anything else. In conclusion, we can't say anything. Nescafe base continues to rock our world. Excuse the pun. Pun fully intended. And yeah, good job to everybody on this track. And of course, Zulfi. Loved it. Thank you for requesting it. So as you can see, DMs mein requests aate hain, toh hote hain, complete. So that's where you head if you want to request any more tracks. And please recommend more have missed from Nescafe Basement. And check out Ms. Bola's channel, linked below in the description. We are going to take your leave and see you in the next one. Bye.
Thank you. Bye.
Long and prosper.